Using our robot technology, we're able to go from approximately 1,600 hours of labor to paint these inlets to around 300 hours. So it really solves our problem in getting these aircraft back into service quicker. We expect to save the Air Force around $28 million in cost. What the Air Force has done in the past by using manual labor, which entailed a person putting on a Tyvek suit, crawling into a confined space, laying it on their back, and trying to spray this large circular tube in a consistent manner. If a person is doing it manually, even the best of painters are not going to be able to repeat exactly the same speed that they're moving the paint gun or determine what thickness they're really putting down. So with the robot, we're able to spray the duct a lot faster, a lot more accurate, and use a lot less paint. So right now we have six of these robots on Hill Air Force Base in their F-22 depot. We also have the similar technology being used on F-18 aircraft as well as F-35 aircraft for both Northrop Grumman and Lockheed Martin. There's a lot of other applications out there for this technology, which include other fighter jets such as the F-35 or F-18, F-16, as well as bombers and a lot of the different missile programs that are out there. With the SBIR program, we've doubled employment. As far as our warehouse and facilities, we've doubled in size, as well as our revenue has doubled as well. We're currently talking with a lot of the management with the F-16 program, and we're hoping we can introduce the same technology into their warfighter as what we've done with F-22. Without the Air Force SBIR program, we would not have been able to do what we've done to this day. Being a part of this really gives us a sense of pride in seeing one of the best fighter jets that the Air Force has get back into service a lot quicker. And when we see the aircraft flying overhead, knowing that we had a hand in making it what it is, really gives you a sense of accomplishment.